Peter, what do we know about this?
So this is a pretty big strategic move for Nvidia. Intel has long been the dominant player in personal computer processors. You'll remember back in the PC era, it was essentially the trio of Intel, Microsoft, and Dell that really dominated this market. Intel was by far the most powerful company in the world. Since then, things have changed a lot. Of course, we do most of our computing over smartphones now. Intel tried to get into the chips for smartphones, but it was never very successful at that, in part because its chips use so much power, it would kill the batteries quite quickly. Now what we're seeing is Nvidia, which is a leader in graphics chips and AI chips, is moving into the personal computer space that Intel has dominated so long. Nvidia is trying to use Arm chips to be able to move into that space. They're developing these new chips. They're aiming to get something on the market in 2025. This would run on Windows, the Windows operating system, just like the Intel chips today. So it's a pretty big strategic threat for Intel.
Yeah, and the market told us that. I mean, the stock we're showing on the screens, I mean, closed 3% lower and already off lows of the day, Peter. So that takes me into my question, really. Is Nvidia in a position, really, to pose a significant challenge? You know, how successful could the company be here in this endeavor?
Yeah, Intel certainly has big ambitions here and elsewhere. The company started out with graphics processors that were very good for gaming in particular. And since then, it's moved into the AI space. It's really become the leader in chips that train these AI models, including ChatGPT. You can see that reflected in its market price. It's the first chip company to breach a $1 trillion market valuation. It's still about that level. In the meantime, Intel has fallen on hard times. Its market value is about $140 billion at this point. So certainly Intel has had a lot of momentum recently, and as it moves into this space, it could present challenges. ARM creates the designs that chipmakers like Nvidia use to be able to make these processors. ARM has been trying to move into servers in particular, and now with Nvidia trying to move into this personal computer space. So over the long term, this is a big issue for Intel, which has been struggling with its production capabilities. It's fallen behind some of the leaders in the market, including TSMC and Samsung in particular.